Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.2, Problem 3. This is Section 2.2, Problem number 3. It says, fill in the blanks in the frequency distribution shown below. And we have a frequency distribution, and about half of the spots in it are blank. So you can really start in many different squares. So you can start anywhere you want. The more you fill in, the easier it's going to get. You can go from left to right or whatever you see first. I'll start on the left. I see the class here. This is a group frequency distribution, actually. It goes from 33 to 38. So now, one thing that I remember from this is there's no gap and no overlap in classes. So if this class ends at 38, the next one has to start at 39. You can't have a gap, like I can't start at 40, and you can't have overlap if this one ends at 38. I can't start this one at 36, let's say. It's got to start at 39. So that gives me something to start with. Now, the classes should be the same width, and I can see to go from the starting point to the ending point of the class that's given, I add 5. 33 and 5 is 38. So the next one I would also add 5. 39 and 5 is 44. And again, same process. No gap and no overlap. If one ends at 44, the next one must begin at 45. And again, to get from the beginning point of the class to the ending point of the class, I'm adding 5. So 45 and 5 more would give me 50. Now, there's one more class before that, a smaller class that's also blank. Same type of process. Well, if the class that's given begins at 33, the one before must end at 32 if there's no gap and no overlap. And something plus 5 added up to 32. Well, 27 and 5 is 32. So I filled in the left column. Now, the frequencies, I have a couple of missing frequencies and relative frequencies. So again, that's the total of all the frequencies in the denominator and the frequencies in the numerator. So I can see that my frequencies total up to 60. This frequency, 45 through 50, is 11 for this class. So the next one up, the next class up, has a frequency of 24, so its relative frequency is 24 over 60. Now, the next class up from there, the frequency part is blank, so I don't know this. I'll come back to this one. But the class above that one has a frequency of 12. And again, I know from the given class total of all the frequencies is 60. So I have 12 over 60. And now what I remember is that the total of the relative frequency column must add up to 1. Or in other words, when my denominator is 60, it would be 60 over 60 because that's 1. So let's see what I have so far. 12 over 60 plus 24 over 60 would be 36 over 60. 36 plus 11 would be 47 over 60. So 47 over 60 plus some unknown amount over 60 would have to add up to 60 over 60, which is 1. It would reduce to 1. So what's the missing amount? Well, 47 and 13, right? I can see that easy enough. If you can, just take your calculator and do it this way. The 60 minus the 47, you'll see that it must be 13. So my missing relative frequency is 13 over 60, which means the last missing piece, the frequency, would be 13, the numerator of the fraction, and now all the blank spots are filled in.